I'm sure that at some point or another, most of you have tried some sport or extracurricular activity that you just sucked at. Maybe you were trying out for football one day, and you realized that even though you were a ninth grader in high school, you were 5'0", 100 pounds, and you were gonna get murdered out there. Maybe you tried out for the swim team, and you sank to the bottom of the pool in 10 seconds. Maybe you tried to start painting, and you realized you couldn't even draw a stick figure. Whatever it was, it's okay. You know, not every hobby is for us. You probably just set it down and decided, I'll try something new. I'll find my niche. Now, in second grade, I was still experimenting with what sport I wanted to do for my school career, you know? I had tried soccer at that point. I was really interested in football, but it didn't seem like something I'd like to play. The next logical option was basketball. Now, after a few practices and games, I realized that basketball just wasn't for me. So I asked my mom and dad, hey, can I quit the basketball team? It just isn't that fun for me anymore. And they told me, no, you can't. If you do, you're gonna have to go to every single member of your team and every single coach, and you're gonna have to look them in the eye, and you're gonna have to tell them I'm a quitter and I can't finish this basketball season because I'm not strong enough. Now, I couldn't really handle the emotional and social scarring that would have caused me. So I finished the basketball season, and that didn't cause any scarring, but it sure did suck. I don't have any proof of my statistics. They're not online anywhere. This was like 10 years ago, and it was like some kids' club basketball team or something like that from my little elementary school. That stuff isn't a big deal. It doesn't get posted online, especially not like 10, 12 years ago. I don't have any proof of what my actual stats were, but when I was a little kid, numbers were one of my very special interests. I just remembered numbers. I was like super good at math, and I just kept track of like all of my own stats for the season. And I remember I sucked. The most important statistic that I remember is that I did not make a single basketball shot the entire season. I went 0-for-6 on field goals. I don't believe I got to attempt a free throw. I did have 3 blocks, or maybe 2 blocks, but I did have a number of blocks that I can count on one hand. But I just could not shoot, and I couldn't pass the ball very well either. Another important basketball statistic is minutes played. They try to get every kid some minutes every single game because it was second, third grade basketball, you know, like, players are interchangeable. None of us were good. All of us were just trying to have fun and stay active. Except for me, I wasn't having any fun. Anyway, they tried to get like every kid like 10 minutes per game or something like that. I probably had about 2 minutes per game. I probably played about 15 minutes over the course of the whole season. And that was because every single game I left crying because I was just so upset about how I couldn't do anything. I couldn't do anything remotely competent. I could not shoot a basket. Every time I passed the ball, it got turned over. Even if I blocked a shot, it would like hurt my finger, it would like bend it backwards, and that made me cry. So I was just like the most pathetic child basketball player. The refs would always stop the game for me. I would always be hustling, and then like ball would get past my way and I'd miss it and I'd start crying. And probably my parents were embarrassed at that point. I don't believe there's any videos surviving of these experiences because I was just so embarrassed by them and I didn't want them out there. It was a bad season, all right? Needless to say, I never played on a basketball team after that. It wasn't for me. I started swimming after that, actually, and that suited me well for a long time. I do have to say one really good thing did come out of my basketball season. I started to get to play with some of the kids at recess. Because even though I was terrible, they still were super kind to me, and they saw me as a friend. I remember, like, this is one of my favorite memories from elementary school that I still have. I remember I went to, like, the opposite side of a basketball court that nobody was playing on, and I just decided, I'm just gonna chuck a ball. I'm just gonna try a full court shot. Now, I got a running start, and it wasn't, like, quite full court, but it was like 3/4 of the you know, the little elementary school basketball court that we had. It was a long shot. I threw that ball so high. After I threw it, I was like, where did the ball go? I just looked at the hoop because I was like, I'm not gonna find the ball. It was like in the sky, and the sun was in my eyes. I couldn't find it. About a second later, it just goes thunk, and the ball goes right through the hoop from like three quarters court, and the whole freaking hoop was rattling. And my reaction was like, oh my gosh, I actually made that. And that was like pretty much the extent of my reaction. But like every single one of the kids on the playground, all the guys who were like playing basketball who were on my team, they're like, oh my god, he actually I can't believe it. He never made a shot all season, but he just made three-quarter court. And then they were like, they came and like picked me up and they like carried me across the basketball court and stuff. And that was like the most significant I had ever felt at that point in my life, and it was pretty fun. So anyway, yeah, my second grade basketball stats sucked, but I did make some friends along the way. So I think sports, even if you suck at them, even if you're trying to hobby out and you are not ever going to be successful at it, sometimes if you can do it with other people, it might be worth it. That's about it. See you guys.